गुड डे एवरीवन। सो वी आर ऑन द फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑफ द कोर्स ऑन कंप्यूटर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड आर्किटेक्चर। एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एड्रेसिंग मोड्स इन ग्रेट डिटेल। सो एड्रेसिंग मोड्स विल बी द फोकस ऑफ दिस लेक्चर। Okay, let me define the addressing mode. Do we mean by an addressing mode? Basically, addressing mode, it refers to the way in which operand of an instruction is specified. Mechanism of specifying operands in an instruction. Depending upon the addressing mode, what kind of addressing mode we are used, this specifies, addressing mode specifies a rule for interpreting the operands or for interpreting the value of the operands. Okay, so whenever we have some instruction, and every instruction it has to execute some operation on some data. How this data is accessed, where is this data, location of the data, this is determined by the type of addressing mode we are using for a particular operand. For example, if I have a data in register R1 and another data in register R2. So here data is D1, in register 2 data is D2. Now let us say we want to add these two data items and place the result in another register R3. Okay, so what we will do, so this type of notation, this notation I am presenting here, it is called a register transfer notation. For example, if I write R1 and then this back arrow R2, that means the data of R2 is transferred into R1, or we can say copied into R1. So this type of notation is used to understand the functionality of an assembly instruction, and this notation is called register transfer notation. So let's come back here. So we have data items, two data items stored in registers R1 and R2, and we want to add these two values and put the value in R3. So my instruction should be, I should have an opcode. So opcode is add, then the operands. So what are the operands? There are two source operands. Who are the two source operands? R1 and R2, and one destination operand, that is R3. I will write R3, R1 and R2. So writing R1 and R2 here, it means that we have to get the value of operand from these registers R1 and R2. So simply writing the name of a register, this type of addressing mode, this is also one addressing mode where we simply write the name of a register. This type of addressing mode means that we have to get the value of the operands from these registers. So when I am adding this, when I am writing this instruction, my computer system or my processor will interpret this instruction, first it will bring out this opcode. Now after getting the opcode, it will find out the operands. And the type of addressing mode I am using for the operands will determine how my processor should get these values. So in this case, the processor should read the value stored in R1, that is D1. It should read the value stored in R2, that is D2. And it will add these two values and then put the value in, final value in R3. So the complete operation will be D1 will be the contents of R1. So when I am writing this square bracket, and inside a square bracket we have a register name. That means we want the contents of this location of this register. So the contents of this register are D1. And what is the content contained in register R2? R2 is D2. And then these two valves are added and the result is put in R3. Okay. So you understand the notation also, register transfer notation also. If I am writing like this, it means get the value contained in R2. R. Contents of the register. If I am writing like this, for example, I have two brackets and inside is R. So this inside portion, this one with a single bracket, this says get the contents of R. Contents of R. Okay, let's say contents of R is X. So now if we rewrite this forum, it will be bracket. So for the inside square bracket one, we are writing X and then this. So X is some value. Okay. So this means get the content stored at X, because the square bracket means get the content stored at X. So the contents, we have to go to the memory. Okay, in this scenario, if we have some constant value inside a square brackets, that means this constant value is the address of memory. And if there is simply a register inside square brackets, it means the value of this register. And here a constant means we have to go to the memory. At this particular location, at this X, we have to get the data. Let's suppose data is D. So this double brackets means that first get the value from the register and then go to the memory location at that particular value and get the data item stored at that location. Okay, this is kind of notation here. So let's go back to the addressing modes. What I was saying, that an addressing mode is a mechanism to specify operands in an instruction. Okay, so after this, if we have an instruction for a particular ISA, when we are designing an ISA, we have to keep this in mind, that what kind of addressing modes we want to use for our instructions. For example, there are some ISAs which are using only 2 to 3 addressing modes, 2 to 3 ways of specifying operands in an instruction. But there are some other ISAs that are using more than 10 addressing modes for specifying operands in an instruction. So today what we will do, we will read about some of the commonly used addressing modes, because there are आई थिंक 10 to 20 एड्रेसिंग मोड्स, एंड ईच इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट आर्किटेक्चर हैज दे आर ब्रिंगिंग सम न्यू एड्रेसिंग मोड्स इन देयर आई से. बट इन दिस लेक्चर, इन टूडेज लेक्चर, वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज एड्रेसिंग मोड्स. ओके, सो लेट मी स्टार्ट विद सम ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज एड्रेसिंग मोड्स. लेट स्टार्ट एंड डिस्कस अबाउट देम वन बाई वन. द फर्स्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड is the register direct mode. Okay, in register direct mode, the value of operand, is contained in the register. Okay, if I have a register R and it contains the value of operand, the operand on which I want to perform some operation, then in that scenario we have to use register direct mode. Okay, so for example here I am writing one instruction move R1 comma R2. So this is how we write. This means take the contents of R2. So that means the value of operand is contained in R2. Take the value of the operand and place it in R1. So we will write it like this. R1. Take the contents of R2 and place it in R1. So this type of addressing mode where the operand is present into the value of an operand is present into the register is called a register direct mode. The second type of addressing mode is register indirect addressing mode. In register indirect addressing mode, the value of operand let's say the operand is, the value of operand is D. The value of operand is not contained in the register. In the first case, the value of operand was present into the register. That is why we used register direct mode. Register indirect addressing mode, this type of addressing mode is used when the value of an operand is not present in the register. Instead, this value is present in memory at some location, let's say at location X. So the value of operand is present in memory at a location X. Okay. However, this X, this address of memory location where our data item is present, this address is stored in the register, let's say in register R. Okay, what I am saying that the value of an operand is not present in the register. Instead, it is present inside the memory. And the address of that memory, that particular location where our data item is present, that address is stored in the register. So we write it like this. For example, if I have to move this data item into register R2, then I will write this instruction like this. Move R2 comma R1. So this means when we are writing the register inside the square brackets, it means that for this operand we are using register indirect mode. Register indirect mode means that this register, this R1 register, it does not contain the value of an operand. Instead, it contains the memory address. So how will we execute this instruction move R2 and square brackets R1. How will we execute it? We will first read the contents of R1. We will take the contents of R1. So what are the contents of R1? What is there in R1? In R1 we have X. What is X? X is the address of memory where our data item is present. So first of all, from R1 we will get X or address. Whose address? Memory's address. And this address is called effective address. So in register indirect addressing mode, what is there in the register that is using register indirect mode? In that particular register, we have an effective address. Okay. After getting this effective address, we will go to the memory at this particular location at X, and we will read the operand value from there. So we will get an operand from there. After getting the operand, we will put this value in R2. So in terms of register transfer notation, how will we write it? R1, we will write it like this. Okay, so this means the inner square bracket says get the contents of R1. So what are the contents of R1? X. Okay, then the outside bracket means get the contents stored at this X. Stored at this X. And where, what is this X? This is the address of memory location where our data item is present. If I write like this, in an instruction I am writing this, move R2. Can you tell me how we will execute this instruction? The first of all, what we have to do is we have to get the value of the operand. Value of an operand. Okay, so let's leave this outer bracket. Let's see the inner bracket. This inner bracket. What does this mean? It means that R1 stores the address of memory. So from this, we will get the address of memory, or we will say the effective address. Effective address. So we got the effective address. Okay. Now the second bracket with the X means the operand is not present at the X. If there was simply there was a single bracket R1, that means first we have to get the address. Address will be X. Now, is there any other square bracket? No. That means this address stores the operand, the value of an operand. Here, the first bracket gives us the effective address, but the second bracket means that the data item is not present at X. Instead, let's say this was X and it was storing X2. Okay. Instead, what we have to go to this location, this X location, and get the value from this location. And what is the value at this location? That is X2. So this X2, this address stores the actual value. So X2 will be here and it will contain some value D. So that means R2 will be like this. So in register indirect addressing mode, there was a single bracket, and single bracket says that effective address. What is the effective address? Let me repeat it again here. Effective address is the final address of of memory that contains the value of an operand. Okay, so in this scenario where we are right, if I have a single R1, that means the value is contained in the register. There is no concept of effective address. If I have like this, that means R1 stores the effective address. Okay, that means if R1 has X, so this X, this memory location stores the value of an operand. However, if we have like this, okay, so we have to first get from R1, we will get X. So X is not the effective address. Effective address is the address that contains the value, but X does not contain our final value. Instead, X stores another value, X2. We have to get that X2, and this X2, this memory location, stores our final value D. And this X2 is the effective memory address. Okay, so these are the two addressing modes, register direct mode. This means the operand is present, the value of an operand is present in the register. In register indirect addressing mode means the value of an operand is present at a memory location X, and that X is stored in R1. So R1 stores the memory address. Okay. The third addressing mode is memory direct mode. Okay. In memory direct mode, in this addressing mode, the operand is present in memory. The same was there in the register indirect mode also. Operand was present in the memory. Okay, let's suppose operand is present at memory location X. This is the value of operand D, and it is stored at location X. In register indirect mode also, we have the value of operand at location D. However, in register indirect mode, this X was stored in some register, let's say R2, and then we used to do move R1, comma R2. Okay, we are giving the register that contains the effective address. Okay, however, in memory direct mode, the mechanism is similar. Move R1, comma. Instead of giving the register, we are directly giving the address in the register. So this is called a memory direct mode. So that means this memory address stores the value of an operand. In register indirect mode, this register was storing the address of memory location where our operand is present. However, in memory direct mode, the effective memory address is directly given inside the instruction. Okay. The fourth part one is memory indirect mode. Memory indirect mode means that in an instruction we have an address X. However, this memory address X, this does not store the it does not store the value of an operand. Instead, it stores some other value that points to some other memory location, and that particular memory location contains our data. It was like this, like I said, memory indirect mode is So the first memory access, in the first memory access, we will find out the actual location that contains our data. Then in the second memory access, we will find our data. So in register indirect mode, in memory indirect mode, we have to do two memory accesses to get our data. The first memory access will be to find the address which actually contains the data, and the second memory access will be to get the data. So this is memory indirect mode. Okay, so memory direct mode says the value, the effective address, or the address where our data item is present, that is located at this memory location. However, in memory indirect mode, we are saying the effective address, the address of a memory location that contains our data, that particular address is stored at this memory location, at X memory location. So this is memory indirect mode. So we will continue our lecture, the second part of this lecture, and we will go through the other addressing modes in detail, and we will see why there is need of having different addressing modes. Why can't we have a single addressing mode and use the same addressing mode for all instructions instead of having different addressing modes? So let's meet in the part 2 of lecture 4. Till then, goodbye.